So from a global perspective, as the model of agriculture in the U.S. has kind of gone out globally, and we have seen a lot of negative effects environmentally from an animal perspective, from a human perspective, are there other countries around the world that are doing a better job of taking care of this industrialized animal production?
Yes, there are indeed, and I think that's what really gives us hope for change, that in fact, in many specific areas, as well as more holistically, other countries have in fact managed this whole industry, if you will, better. Certainly, it probably all started in Scandinavia, where there was a great deal of public concern about a range of aspects of industrial agriculture, certainly related to disease, unsafe food, animal welfare. And that was sufficient to cause governments to look into how the industry had developed and the relative lack of controls. I say relative because most of those countries had always been doing things that we're still struggling to do. For example, getting accurate information on the use of antibiotics in food animal production, having the right to inspect facilities and to require changes, empowering veterinarians in a real way, and also giving them the responsibility of managing the use of drugs as well as the care of animals in a way that has not happened here. So I think that those paths are there and have been shown to work. And in fact, in many of the countries, they actually took it one step forward and gathered the evidence where they collected information on antibiotic-resistant pathogens within farms, on animals, on food products, and then finally even within hospitals. And they showed that some of the steps they had taken to ban the use, for example, of specific drugs, played out in terms of reducing the risks all the way through the pathway from farm to fork, if you will. So I think the fact that it can, in fact, make a difference has also been shown. But one of the real problems we have here, I think, is that this is truly a global issue. We now know, well, food is a global product. We source a lot of our food from other countries. Bacteria move in many ways in the guts of people when they travel, animals move about. So we've got to find a way, which is what the WHO is working on, to have a globally harmonized, agreed upon set of recommendations. Because in fact, no matter what happens in the EU, where a lot has happened, you're never going to get rid of the whole problem as long as you have countries like the United States, which is not doing very much of anything. Because we know that, for instance, some of the most recent, really worrying, multi-drug resistant bacteria that have come out have made their way from discovery first in a pig farm in China, 2 weeks later being found in England, and a week after that found in Canada. So this is a global problem and needs a global set of parameters and guidance.
That's very interesting. You brought up China, and I was going to ask about that, because the livestock market there is immensely larger than our own. The number of production animals that they have is larger than our own, and there's even less government regulation.
Well, it would be hard for me to think of less government regulation than us. I'm serious.
Yeah.
When people say that, and I have students say who come from Africa, and they say, oh, but it's much worse in our country. I said, I'm not really sure of that.